And now Joan is here on the program. He is the head coach of the Wolverines. In fact, he has led San Bernardino Valley to back-to-back trips to conference championship games going into his, I can't believe I'm saying this, his fourth season as head coach at SBVC. It's Daniel Algattas. Are you really going on year number four?
Yeah, it's year four, getting better every year. So trying to just continue that trend this year.
Well, Coach, I have to point out because you can't tell, but I'm in my dining room. But you are in the SBVC intergalactic headquarters where are you broadcasting from out of there now? What's going on as you try to make this this transition into coaching football and getting ready for the season while still being at home?
Well, we had actually ordered, thousands of dollars worth of camera and production equipment to have our own on-campus documentary, and hired a whole video team, and all that stuff came in and it was sent to my house. And then we were told, hey, we're not going back to school right away. So we get the lighting set up and all that stuff. I got into football because of video and stuff like that, and able to use the computers and stuff like that. It was, the first coaching job for everybody is video stuff. So yeah, kind of put it back to work.
Well, I'm just waiting for the invite. I should be doing this show at your house.
Soon as we're safe and good to go and our wives will let us, then we'll do it.
Well, Coach, maybe going into this season, the biggest difference will be the change in conference, obviously. You guys had a great run in the American Conference, won a lot of football games. Now you go to the National Conference. The caliber of competition, I guess it would be safe to say it's going to be ratcheted up quite a bit. Do you embrace that challenge of playing some really good college football teams this upcoming season?
Yeah, absolutely. I think we have the talent to do it. Going this recruiting season, we feel really good about where we were, and then adding on with the ability to go up to the next level, being able to be successful, set records, get guys out, having guys getting drafted from, my previous stops, they're getting drafted this year, and kind of, showing that everything's kind of still continuing. We're still having success and we're still able to help guys, achieve their dreams. Just having a great coaching staff at this place to help all these guys as they come in and help them get it out. It's good. If you want to be the best, you have to play the best, and, we have to play them, they have to play us. So it's, everybody's getting what they want.
Is it kind of twofold at being the head coach of the Wolverines, that obviously you're there to win football games, but also you're trying to help these guys get to the next level? Most of them are, if not all of them, have aspirations of continuing their college football career somewhere, right?
Certainly. And I think all of that stuff is process oriented. Just like Bill Walsh's book, the score takes care of itself. I think the transfer deal, same way. So we try to, get these guys as focused as possible, point them in the right directions as student athletes, as young men, things like that. If we're able to do however you want to define it for that particular year, and then, as transfers go, if they're going to class and they're getting their things done, they're taking advantage of all the resources that we have available to them, and they're on a winning team and they know how to, they know how to play team football and do those things, it will take care of itself. So, but yeah, that's something that we definitely push for. We want to get them out. We don't want to just win games and not be able to get guys out. We don't want to just, you can't really get guys out if you're not winning games. So those two things are, do go hand in hand. But yeah, I mean, it's bittersweet when you see, like this year we had 9 freshmen leave, 7 of them left, at the break. They'd only been with us for 6 months, and then they all signed, they signed scholarships. So it's bittersweet, but I was a freshman who got to sign out of a junior college and got to leave. So it's something that that I understand. You love your time there, but if you don't need to be there and you're going to have somebody else pay for it, then you should move on and get it taken care of.
So, Coach, let me ask you this then. So, numbers wise, you're talking about guys moving on, and you had a great class, including quarterback Jeremy Musa. Who's staying? Who's coming back this fall? And who are some of the new guys? If you could do a little name dropping, who are some of the guys that we should look out for this season?
Yeah, well, returning back from the 2018 team is receiver DJ, who is a big deal for us. He's going to move from number 88 to number one. So having him come back into the fold is going to be, is going to be great. Tyjon Calhoun, a slot receiver, will will be back. Deonze Nolan at receivers. On the offensive side, that's, you know, coming back over there. On the defensive side, you do have, you know, the same thing. You do have a lot of retooling on that side as well. So not as many familiar names. The whole defensive backfield signed scholarships, and so they move on, with the exception of Claude Dent, also out of North High School. He was first team all conference, and so he'll return. The linebacking core gets overhauled. We run a 4-2, so we're only talking about two guys. So up there, and then you know, up front, we have a few linemen coming back, but really, you're going to see some guys that gray shirted, some guys that red shirted, and are coming back from the 2018 championship team. So you get kind of the returners from 2 years coming back, and then our strongest recruiting class that, you know, SBVC's had in a long, long time. You know, according to everybody who's on campus, they say we haven't seen people this on campus or this athletic looking on campus as it pertains to football, at least in a long, long time. And so I think those are things that we had heard at the last couple places we were at, that we turned those ones around. So that's what we're looking for. We're bringing on, you know, great football players that are going to represent the community well, pretty well. And, you know, just put the whole thing together and try to get them to work together as a team. Obviously, we're not together right now. So, you know, finding ways to do that through Zoom or through Skype, things like that are fun. Yeah.
So, Coach, what would you, normally be doing right now to get ready for a football season? And what are you doing right now? Because like you said, you could do Zoom calls, you can stay in touch with your coaching staff, some of your players for the fall. So what are ways that you can, you know, find, you know, be innovative to find ways to still kind of push forward and be ready for that first game of the year?
Well, yeah, I mean, this, like you said, this is Command Central. So coming up in about 50 minutes, we have our next quarterback meeting. And so with those quarterback meetings, they get, you know, they use control of the computer, the TV behind me. You can write directly on it and trying to do all of those things. Obviously, when you have all the production equipment we have, we're not really tied to anything, and we're able to have, you know, a few different camera angles and do those things. So I'm not so much prohibited from teaching and communicating and doing all of those things. It's the reps on the field that we're missing. So we'd probably be finishing up on the, you know, on the field, or finishing up video after practice at this point right now, but we're actually going to be going into video later in the day, trying to give everybody enough time to, not only for them to do all their homework, get all that out of the way, and relax for a little bit. That's when they're all the way turned on. That's what they said. So, you know, that's when we're having our meetings later in the afternoon or in the evening, trying to do things like that. So, yeah, kind of just getting started with the second set of meetings here for the day. And yeah, so doing that, having them take tests, having them take control, you know, having them walk through. They kind of look silly sometimes, you know, on their desk. I can only see, you know, their stomach or something like that, because they're standing up right in front of the computer doing their drops and trying to, you know, react on time to doing those things. So still trying to get all those reactions and somehow find a way to do mental reps. So, yeah, we had to order them all Rubik. So that are coming in Amazon in the mail, so.
Coach, you cut out just a little bit, but I'm pretty sure you said you had to get them all Rubik's Cubes, right? Especially your quarterbacks, because you need them very smart, very cerebral.
Yeah, we just want them to have a plan ahead of time before they go. So used it as a story, and now they're sent, they're in the mail, they're doing some of those things. You know, some of the same reaction drills that race car drivers do, you know, both in training and then pre-race, things like that. We're trying to have them do some of those things as well. So those are there are a lot of things that they can do without, you know, heavy weights or expensive equipment, that they can do to work on reactions and try to, you know, how to be better at making decisions or trusting their instinct and pulling triggers and those kind of things. So that's what we're working on. Everything that we can think of, we do. So we pull from a lot of other sports at this point to find all the things that we can do from a distance or at home.
Well, Coach, we always appreciate the time. And again, when all this safe at home stuff blows over, I'd love to come check out the intergalactic headquarters for the Wolverines, because your setup is obviously great. A lot better than mine.
It's getting there. It's almost there. My wife agreed to let me to paint and soundproof the room next. So next week it'll look a little bit different again. So it'll be good.
Well, you are light years ahead of everybody else. That's Daniel Algattas, the head coach at SBVC. Again, we're looking forward to another big college football season as he goes into year number 4. Coach, we always appreciate the time, and we'll do this again very, very soon. And hopefully by the time we talk again, we'll maybe have some like on the field training or, you know, cardio or something where you guys can actually get together as a group and start doing stuff, team activities.
Yeah, that'd be great.